All right, spent about a half hour, got the inside door panel off. Used a trusty Harbor Freight $8 heat gun and got the molding off. There's some locating holes and double back tape. That's really all that holds that thing on. Beauty of it is, once I got it off, even as wrinkled as it was, seemed to be pretty flat, so I think I can probably reuse this piece. Got some scuff marks that'll come out, no doubt. But otherwise, I think once the body panel's flat, this thing should lay back flat on there. What I've done is tried to go and highlight some of the areas where the pressure lines are, as far as where the hit actually occurred. Now, right about in here, it was an 8 foot tall pole wrapped in some kind of goofy plastic or whatever. I have no idea, right next to the curb where you turn. And after going back and looking at it, I wasn't the first one to hit it. So anyway, not blaming anybody else, my own stupid fault. This truck has really crappy turning radius, and making a right turn, it's fairly blind. And so you have a tendency, especially with a fairly long curb, and you cut it short. And I'm always trying to be real careful about it, but screwed up this time. Anyway, bottom line is I can walk along here and you can see, hopefully the light's reflecting, you can see where my highs and lows are. And haven't really done this kind of work for a long time. I was thinking about it, I thought, well, maybe I'll just take a grease pencil and you know, kind of outline some of the areas before I go in and try and press some of it out without, you know, really taking it down to the metal as yet. So what I did is use a grease pencil and kind of looked along the lines, tried to outline it, and then put a plus if the area was high and a minus if it was low, just to kind of give me some visual of what I've got. And what I, you know, what I can see here is that the actual indentation starts around in this area. Let me get my finger back in here. If I widen that a little bit, okay. So anyway, the pressure area starts right in here and dips in, and then I've got a high area right in the middle, a low area. Try this again. I'm not used to using a damn camera either. All right, let's try this one more time. Got a high area coming into it, starts to dip down, and then, hope this pencil's showing up on there. Then I've got a high area in the middle. There is actually a crash bar, tubular crash bar that runs along the back of this, and that, I don't know that that went in at all, but anyway, those are some pressure points where, you know, the sheet metal butted up against it tight. The other parts of it gave in between, so I've got this kind of a effect going on. I come back here, I've got a low area, at least looking at it in the light and reflection, then a high area, then it comes back down, and it's a little high at this body line, and comes down, and it kind of buckled right in here, pushed in deep, and then popped all this area out. Actually, I find this works a lot better. I wasn't looking at the little LCD screen. So if I watch my hand, I can see where we're going. And then I crushed in this pillar here. Because I've got a little bit of a buckle back here. I can feel it, doesn't really show up in at least fluorescent lights I'm using in here, but I know it's there. That one's not real bad. I'll worry about that when I get to it. I'm more concerned about getting this area cleaned up, because this is pretty well effed up. So anyway, the door is popped out down the bottom. I have to work that back in. But I think the first thing I'm going to do is go back in here, and I'm going to work along that crash bar and see if I can't use a little tool and try and just kind of pop some of this. Use a cup on the outside, maybe a suction of some sort. Don't know if I'll be very, you know, lucky at it or not, but we'll see what it does. I've tried to use the heat gun to get this, whatever the heck this this glue is on here. I mean, it's pretty much a nightmare. and then tried to scrape it without digging into the metal too much, but it's like a real pain to get off. Used a plastic spatula and just melted that damn thing. So I know this stuff's getting hot enough, but it gets kind of gummy, but it cools so quickly, and it's not all that warm out here in the garage. Probably about 45 degrees or so. So anyway, that's where we're at. And if I run along here, you can see some of the stuff I'm dealing with. And yeah, right in there. Got some whoop-de-doos. Mr. Milrick would say a little something-something going on. So anyway, I'm going to come down here. And I've got a little bit going on down here, not too much. Again, it seems like the brunt of it was the body came out like this. It took it right on the molding, which was fortunate. And, you know, pushed in from there, wherever it couldn't push in. Hitting the crash bar, you know, became lower. So anyway, I'm going to go in there and start pulling that, pressing that out, see if I can gain anything out of it. This will show up in here. This camera doesn't have a light on it, but there's a crash bar right here, and it feels pretty damn straight. So I think, you know, it didn't really, I don't feel any deformation at all in it. And there's another smaller one up here, but this is the guy that takes the brunt of it and obviously kept the whole damn door from caving in. So that's where we are, and I'll turn it back on when I see if I can get a little bit of results here.